There's a house here. I don't know if somebody lives here. Let's check it out.
Good morning, internet. It is 8:36 in the morning and welcome back to the channel. I am walking in a town called Toluín in the Argentinian part of Tierra del Fuego. And I just had my breakfast, which was quite nice. It was a toast with jam and some yogurt with muesli. But what I'm gonna do now is go to the bakery. There's a bakery around the corner here. And buy a lunch, because I don't think I will find anything to eat around lunchtime where I'm gonna go today. I'll show you on the map later where I'm gonna go today, what is the plan. But what I do know is that in total it's about 285 kilometers that I'm riding today. Probably two-thirds will be off-road, I think, and then a little bit of paved. Weather is still pretty okay. There are some dark clouds, but I think they'll go. At least I hope so. Very nice place. When I leave this town, I will see if I can make a small round, because this town is right at a lake, and I think it's actually that same lake that I saw in the last ride, but then the other side of the lake. I think, I'm not 100% sure if it's two lakes or if it's connected, to be honest. See, there's a panaderia, bakery. Yeah, they have a library here in the fridge. See that? It says leave one and take one. Pretty cool. Why not? Okay, let's see if we can get a lunch here. Ooh. I got myself a roll and a vegetable empanada. An empanada is just a pastry, like this. And this one is filled with vegetables. Come in all sorts of shapes, with meat and ham and cheese and all sorts of things. But trying to be a little bit healthy. Lunch is in the pocket. Let's pack up Danol and then hit the road. I am now here in Toluín, which is in the Argentinian part of Tierra del Fuego. And the plan of today is I'm gonna take a dirt track somewhere around here, which basically will lead to the end of the road. So somewhere here the road really ends and then you cannot ride any further south. So that's where I'm gonna go first. And then it's a one-way road, so then I have to go back. And then I continue and then I'll stay the night in Ushuaia.
¿Y esa que tienes ahí es otra cámara?
Sí.
¿Que te va filmando a vos?
Sí.
¿Cómo se llama tu canal de YouTube?
Itchy Boots.
Itchy Boots.
Sí. Para nafta, para acá, ¿no?
¿Para?
Nafta, comprar nafta.
¿Para Ushuaia? Ah, no, para nafta. Okay. Ah, sí. Sí. Haces dos cuadras y después a la izquierda.
Ok, muy bien. Gracias.
Buen
Adiós.
Viaje, Noralí. Buena
Gracias.
Vida.
Chao. Before I go anywhere else, let's just first ride to the lake. Have a look at the lake before I miss that. This should lead to the lake, this truck. Well, according to Maps Me, this track should lead to the lake. I hope that's right. Here's the lake, wow. Very nice spot, beautiful. Beautiful, okay, let's go.
Wow, it is so cool to be here. This water is the Beagle Channel. Amazing, right? So that over there is Chile again. So now I'm standing in Argentina, Beagle Channel, Chile. And then on Chile's side, you can't see it from here, but somewhere over there, there is one town called Puerto Williams. So that is even more south than Ushuaia. But to get there, I heard it's very expensive and you also cannot go with motorbike. There's only a small boat taking passengers, but you cannot bring a vehicle. So there's not much point for me to go there. Incredible place, right? I'll show you on the map where I'm standing now, then maybe it makes more sense. So I am now standing in the purple, somewhere over here. So that land that I show you on the other side of the Beagle Channel, that is this part of Chile. So that's what you see on the other side of the water. And I am somewhere around there. And to the end of the road from here, it's still 27 kilometers. I am here. This is the end of the road. I cannot go no further. There's a house here. I don't know if somebody lives here. Let's check it out. Hola. Bien.
¿Se han fijado aquí?
Sí, acá. Controlamos los barcos acá.
Ah, sí, sí.
Sí, estamos en una estadía, una temporada de un mes y después bajamos de vuelta a Ushuaia. Hacemos cambio.
¿Una semana acá?
Un mes.
Un mes. Uh-huh. Y después en Ushuaia.
Después en Ushuaia seguimos trabajando.
Un mes también. Uno para uno, ¿no?
No, ojalá. Un par de días no vale.
¿Unos días solamente? No, no. ¿Y después un mes acá?
No, no, después cuando nos toque. Nosotros pedimos. Ah. Vamos rotando el personal.
Ah, sí, sí. Ah, ok. Muy bien.
¿De dónde vienen? ¿De dónde venís?
¿Mi país o hoy?
País.
Holanda.
Sí. ¿Y ahora? ¿De dónde?
Hoy de Tolwyn. Tolwyn.
Sí.
Hoy voy a Ushuaia. Y después Alaska.
¿Ya?
¿Alaska en moto?
So it turns out that this is a naval base. I had no idea. I just saw on the map this is the end of the road, so I thought, okay, let's go there. But it turns out to be the prefectura, which is the navy, and they control like the vessels that that come past here. So it's quite nice, and they gave me a coffee and we had a chat and they told me some really cool stories. And when I told them that I'm from the Netherlands, they said like, oh yeah, yeah, there was a guy here a couple of years back. And he went, I don't know, he was here in winter time and he went hiking or something by himself, got lost and he had to be rescued. And that horse over there is from one of the gauchos here. There are two or three gauchos in this area, which still work here with horses, and they have a huge area where the cows just run free. And that gaucho went with that horse to look for this man, and they found him and he was still alive. So that was a happy ending to that story. Anyway, it's a bit of a surreal place. I'm having my lunch now, my empanada with vegetables. And then I'm just, yeah, I'm turning around. So this is the end of the road, this is the furthest I can go. So from now on, I'm going the other way and go to Alaska. Although today I'm going to Ushuaia, which is a little bit further the other way. But yeah, this is the end of the road. And yeah, it's, I don't know, it's a strange feeling to really start now, because I've been calling this trip Patagonia to Alaska, but first I was going to reach Patagonia. So the whole adventure towards Alaska is really starting now. It is now 2 o'clock, and then I first have to go around 90 kilometers back on this dirt road, and then the last bit towards Ushuaia is paved, so that should be all fine.
All right, let's go. Thank you.
we're back at the paved road towards Ushuaia.
Gracias.
Ushuaia. Wow, what a place. Look at it. Incredible, huh? Somewhere, hostel. See if I can stay here.
So they had a place to stay tonight. This is my room. I'm in Ushuaia. I can't believe it. It's quite nice to be here. This was kind of the first real goal of this trip. Just first reach Ushuaia. And I've done the end of the road, and now it's just back up north from here and on to Alaska. In the end, I'm super happy that it stayed dry all day, because the weather didn't look so good, but luckily no rain. And it was actually funny, because when I left the prefectura, so that naval base place, when I was leaving, I was just thinking to myself, what am I doing? This is such a classic moment that I think, the end of the road, I see this building and I just kind of rock up there and just kind of walk into a naval base. Which was just so random. I didn't expect that. I thought this is the end of the road, probably there'll be some sort of sign saying end of the road or something like that, but I had no idea there was a prefectura office there. That was it for today. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up and subscribe down below. And then I'll see you in the next video.